A night out ended in a hail of bullets for a man who was killed and two others who were wounded early Sunday near Kennedy International Airport in Queens, the police said. The victims were sitting at a stoplight on the service road to the Van Wyck Expressway at North Conduit Avenue when two gunmen walked up to their Mercedes-Benz Sport utility vehicle and opened fire, according to the police. The front passenger, Sherwood Beverly, 51, of Brownsville, Brooklyn, was struck in the head. He was pronounced dead at Brookdale University Hospital and Medical Center, the police said. The driver, a 50-year-old man, was grazed on the neck, and a 50-year-old woman in the back seat was hit in the left shoulder. A 44-year-old woman sitting next to her was not injured, according to the police. After the shooting, the driver continued for several miles to the 69th Precinct Station House, where he arrived at 5:19 a.m. seeking help, the police said. He and the woman who was shot in the chest were treated at the hospital. The police said their injuries were not life-threatening. The gunman fled in a dark-colored sport utility vehicle, the police said. Investigators were searching for the gunman and a motive for the shooting, according to the police. At the scene, the police said, detectives found 11 shell casings from a 9mm handgun and two from a .40 caliber weapon. Earlier in the night, the victims had been at a dance club called Mocha in the Richmond Hill neighborhood, the police said. They said they were trying to find out if the conflict might have started there. On Sunday afternoon, the street outside the 69th Precinct Station House was still an active crime scene. Yellow tape surrounded the victim's dark Mercedes-Benz with South Carolina license plates. It sat on Foster Avenue next to Rockaway Parkway with jagged holes where three of the vehicle's four side door windows used to be. A bullet left a crack in the windshield. The shooting occurred on the edge of South Ozone Park, by a residential cluster of homes with fenced walks and driveways tucked between the Van Wyck Expressway and the Belt Parkway. Hours later, investigators walked the rain-soaked crime scene beneath the traffic signal on North Conduit Avenue, stepping around more than a dozen clear plastic drinking cups placed over shell casings on the roadway.